the future home of Super Bowl 56. There's a look at SoFi Stadium just south of downtown Los Angeles. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Los Angeles Chargers. Two teams more than ready to get this one started. And we are underway in Southern California. Well, here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And that's a run that will energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. They go play action. Now Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And this one is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Second and 10. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Well, this defense for the Chargers, they were strong last week, CD, and that went over New England.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
Throwing left side, it's complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down, they did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. From the gun, here's Swift. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line.
Let's go!
Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line.
Let's go, baby. Let's
and they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Here's Swift. And a nice pickup there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They have really moved it well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
And it's caught. Touchdown. DeAndre Swift with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Chiefs 7, Chargers nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Chargers take over first down at their own 25-yard line.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Herbert. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. The first carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and a yard at the 47-yard line.
Herbert now. And that is incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you had. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one.
Coming to you.
Back to throw here, Herbert. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first.
Well, these two teams hooking up for the second time this year. They first met back in October, week 7. And it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Gibson here running out of the gun. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Buying time to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And he comes back with one complete. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. They'll run with Gibson. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Had a chance to maybe limit them to three if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right now, everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defenses just say, okay, new set of downs. It gives us another chance to make a play ourselves and maybe change.
And now a fumble. The ball's out, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Come on now, let's go!
So now, just like that, things change dramatically. It's first and goal. Now Herbert following the turnover. He's going to drop this one down to Gibson. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
On second down, a run with Gibson. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
Now Herbert, third and goal. And this is caught. He's got a touchdown. His second touchdown on the season. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Point after, right down the middle. And we are tied here in the second quarter. Seven now as they kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM, it always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5.
Here's a handoff to Swift. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Mahomes to throw on third and one. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Tremaine Edmonds there to bring him down.
It's second and eight.
8 yards to go on second down. Throwing now is Mahomes. Throw left side complete. That's Peters.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now here's Mahomes. He'll get this off to Swift. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up the first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
Good call there on first down. And Brandon, I'm getting better over the years and not screaming out, screen, screen, screen with my defensive training. They want to keep those pass rushers honest. And they did so there, and they wind up picking up positive yardage.
They go play fake. Mahomes. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. On the handoff, this is Swift. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And defensive back Jamal Adams in on the stop. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing, because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He'll drop this one off to Swift. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Third down, Mahomes. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down.
Yeah, and they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
From the 17, Herbert. He's going to look deep for more. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. A handoff for Gibson. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. So possession goes over here on the punt, and it's Chiefs football, 1st and 10. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a 4th down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a 1st down.
Mahomes now on 1st down. Escaping the pressure right. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now just under 30 seconds to go in this 1st half.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Mahomes to throw once more. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to take over here up near the 40.
And that's what we've seen from this defense all year long because they've been so good at finding ways to take the football away. And they just gave us another example right here. A strong defense, that's something you're going to need to rely on come playoff time. And this crew has got one. There's no doubt about that, Brandon.
After the turnover, here's Herbert. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Here's Herbert. And that is incomplete.
I like what they did there because many of the deep throws we see in the course of a game come to the outside, the perimeter of the field. In this case, they used the slot receiver to run deep downfield and tried to connect that way. Unsuccessful in that attempt, but I like what they were doing.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Here's Herbert. Wide open receiver complete. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show at halftime as they head to the locker room. 7-7 our score. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point.
Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. The Charger drive about to get going.
It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Now it's Herbert. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
And one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about four.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
On is the Chargers punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he's going to hook up with his big tight end. Complete. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about seven or eight. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes.
He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down. Here's the Chiefs punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone.
Now a fair catch taken just across midfield, maybe by a yard or two. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over.
The Charger drive about to get going.
We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. And he's got this down to the 35. 64 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Play action. It's Herbert. Over the middle, complete. It's Peterson. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
From the 31, Herbert. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Peterson. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Set him back 5. The delay of game, a costly one, as they're backed up 5 for first and goal. Shotgun handoff to Gibson. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Antonio Gibson. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Chargers have taken the lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Snap coming at 1, and it's Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the side.
Mahomes hit. He lost the football. And picked up by the Chargers. And now off to the races. Down the right side. And he takes it back to the house. It's a fumble recovery and a Charger touchdown.
This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
Extra point right down the middle. And it's now 21-7.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
A gain of 11 on the play. First down, Chiefs.
Give right side, McElroy, and down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Just a yard to go here on second down. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Chiefs on third down. They've had 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
And that pretty much has been the storyline, Charles. This defense, they seem to be one step ahead from the start of the game until now.
And you identified it perfectly, and we can see the frustration that's settling in now. And it's probably been there for a long time, but now it's evident because you can see it in their faces, you can see it in their body language, maybe even a little bit in that play call. That ended up maybe closing them out.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Peterson. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
On 1st and 10, it's Gibson. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them. trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
On second down, here's Gibson again.
And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now Herbert off the bootleg. Eluding the pressure right. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This to make it a three-score game late. And his kick here is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
Well, you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On second and seven, Mahomes.
That's complete to Swift out of the backfield.
He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The Chiefs on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Not ideal there. That delay of game backs him up 5 yards, so now they need 7 yards on third down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. Mahomes finding Hill for a big play. 57 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
They'll have to deal with a 2nd and 14 now after the loss. Now this time Mahomes will throw.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
The Chiefs on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 and 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 14. To throw, it's Mahomes. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And he's going to come up well shy of the first here as the tackle's made right around the 12. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. Mahomes and the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Now Mahomes got to have this one. Flush to his right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, giving him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball on the way out.
A big play there on the catch and run. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. Give them maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. The Chargers will bring out the field goal unit now. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And his kick is good. And that will push this lead up to 20 now. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory.
but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted.
Derwin James with a pick. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to seven. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. And they'll indeed take a knee. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. And they will take a knee here. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the L.A. Chargers. And, you know, it wasn't a shutout. They did give up the points in the first quarter. But second, third, and fourth quarter, they held them scoreless.
Brandon, if you throw a shutout for quarters 2, 3, and 4, you win a lot of games in this league. And this felt a lot like, almost like if you say baseball, and the pitcher goes through the lineup the first time, and the hitters get to see him. And then they come out after that, and the bats start blazing, right? I think they saw their best stuff in the first quarter and just shut everything down from that point on. What a great, convincing performance.
So for the Chargers, they remain in the hunt for a first-round bye as they move to 11-3 on the year. We'll be right back.